My name is Hannah De Souza Rodriguez, and I teach at the Argenziano School in Somerville.
So we have weathering and erosion. Can you clap erosion?
Erosion.
Lucas, me mostra. Erosão.
I speak Spanish and Portuguese, and I'm learning Haitian Creole with my students. So I use those languages as a direct teaching tool as much as I can so that they can make meaning in their native language and transfer those skills into English.
Aqui temos aprendido, okay? And now we're going to have to apply it to today's job. Our job is posted right here. Today we are going to describe, can you show me describe?
Describe.
A process.
A process
like weathering and erosion. Show me.
Weathering and erosion.
Okay. By using these signal words, first, next, then.
The language objective for today's lesson was to be able to describe the process of weathering and erosion using sequential language and scientific vocabulary, as well as comparative adjectives. We try to break down the objective and make sure that the students understand the language function, which is describe. And then we're looking at our language feature, which is the sequential signal words, first, next, then.
Who can tell me what happens next? Next. Lucas.
Next, the dog passed on the wind and the wind passed around off his head.
Okay. And then the content, which is describing the process of weathering and erosion. We tried to make sure that all of those pieces are well planned and well supported throughout the lesson.
Between.
Inside.
On.
This unit was written for students at entering and developing English language levels. I teach in a self-contained setting where I have the responsibility of teaching content and language all day long, which is really amazing. Right now I have 15 students from all over the world, varying linguistic backgrounds, cultural backgrounds, and formal schooling. We work at the same pace as other classrooms, although our focus on language development is much more explicit.
Is close to the ocean?
Excellent.
I do adapt every year or every even, you know, semester when we're starting the unit, both the content and the language. I try to use landscapes and experiences of weathering and erosion that students are both familiar with and not familiar with, so I get to know my students and where they're from and what they've seen.
We are going to turn and talk using the words first, next, then, about what is happening in this picture. What is that in the picture?
Dog.
Can you help us with the first? First, a dog.
Today, the students worked on creating cohesive sentences using nouns that were scientific vocabulary about the landforms and landscapes, and agents of weathering and erosion, comparative adjectives, prepositions, and verbs. So they had to sequence at least three sentences using the words first, next, and then.
Where does ocean go?
Each group had two photographs, a before and after, of a landscape that had experienced erosion, and they were asked to describe that process that they saw in the photos and also what they thought happened to create change. It was quite a complex task.
Fabrina, you see hills here?
Yeah.
Daily? Okay. Trees?
Yes.
You see trees here?
Yes.
Here?
No.
Yeah. No. Just a little, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And mud?
No.
Yeah.
Where's the mud? Before or after?
After.
And as their language develops and their concept knowledge, they're able to explain and describe better what they know and what they've seen.
What is this?
Hill.
Great. Okay, this is a hill.
First, the houses are on the hills. There are many trees. Next, the rain and the wind wash all the trees. Then the hills have fewer trees.
We try to create a very safe learning environment where all students are comfortable speaking in their native language and both in their developing English. So we make a big deal of applauding and congratulating the smallest steps in terms of progress and just trying. And the students are really comfortable talking with each other orally in a variety of languages. In addition to the unit level assessments and the day-to-day assessments, we have collaborated together as a department in Somerville, the ELL department, to create common assessments that are quarterly.
Look what I have. What is this? Land.
Island.
Do you see an ocean too?
I also like to create a lot of scaffolds and then leave it up to the students to seek them out when and if they need them. So some students did fine putting their own words in the sentence form that they wanted to. Others needed each vocabulary card, and I helped them place it in a sentence frame.
The water, okay. Or look, you have lots of nouns. Beach.
One of the benefits of these ESL MCUs are that not only are students acquiring that academic language in a rich scientific context, but they're also taking on the role of a scientist. So they become confident in the realm of science, how to present their claims, how to describe a physical feature of a landform, and that's really amazing to see.
Next, the sand is broke.
My advice to other teachers would be to really understand it yourself before you try to teach it and share it with a group of students, and make it meaningful to you and your group of students, both content-wise and language. Seeing these lessons come alive in the ESL MCUs is invigorating because the students are motivated and engaged in both the content and they really want to share their ideas and get their thoughts across. So it's fascinating to see them grab onto the language and really try to make sense of it in a way that explains their deep conceptual thinking about science.
Is this your photograph?
Science is experience. It's life and all around us. So students, no matter where they're from, have prior experience, and especially with this unit, we talk about landscapes, weathering, and erosion. And so it's a really rich context to learn really complex language.